Hey guys, what is going on? It is Obediah, and today we are back playing some Ark on the center. Da, 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 da. So, don't worry, we are still definitely playing on the Tameable Alpha server. I just realized that because I have this new job and a new schedule and all that, it's really hard to play with Kat and Bryson and all them and Kevin and people I like to play with. So I'm going to mainly play on there with them, but I figured, hey, we have this other server. And you know what? There's a lot of new people who will join an Ark. A lot of people playing on PlayStation, and a lot of people playing on Xbox, and they can't use mods. So this series is going to be designed for those people. Now, we do have one mod, and it's a stack mod, because I don't ever want to go back to not having a stack mod. It's terrible. But this at least... we did up the rates quite a bit. I think it's 10... or 20 times taming, I don't 10 times taming, something like that, I don't know. Hey, come get out of here! No! Leave me alone! Increased everything. I think it's 5 times experience, 5 times gather, something like that. You can't get me on this rock, stupid. I'm gonna go ahead. Oh, you can get me on the rock! Leave me alone! So I'm gonna go ahead and kind of walk around, see what kind of spot I can find, somewhere that I want to build. I think I want to build up in the, a little bit northwest of here, maybe. I think I have a spot in mind. Ooh, an egg. I'm taking it. Oh, there's a raptor egg. Probably a terrible idea. Oh, you're not a raptor. So I'm gonna go find a spot. Go ahead and get us started, and then I'll bring y'all back. All right, guys, so after a bit of travel, I think I found the spot. So, let's take a look here. We are at about coordinates 30... or 2951. Now, if you're on like Xbox or PlayStation, I don't know if the place in your map is marked, but on official servers on PC, I don't think it is. So that might not help you until you get like a GPS or a compass or something, but that's where we are. I'm thinking I wanna eventually build on pillars and maybe just in this water a little bit, just right above the water. I think that could be really cool. I haven't done anything like that really before, but this is shallow enough we can do that. But I think for now, we gotta get like a hut built. So normally I would just get the stuff started off camera, but because I'm trying to do this as if you're brand new, I'm gonna go ahead and do all this stuff on camera. So I've been gathering stuff, I've been punching stuff for some thatch and wood. There was a dead dino, so I got some hide from it just by punching it. There's a dead spino. I've been getting berries from collecting bushes, and I should have enough stuff to get berries and fiber to get my beginning stuff made. Of course, our gathering rates are turned up, which makes it a bit easier. So first, let's make some clothes, a hat, some boots, some gloves, some shirts, some pants. I'll make a pick, and then we'll let all this stuff be made. Come on. Oh, a sleeping bag. We'll throw it on one of those suckers, because that way if we die, we can respawn right here. All right. Hats. Oh, and we have some skins. Throw that hunter hat skin right on there. Drop all the rest of these things. I hate how you get the skins every time you die. Oh, I also picked up some random eggs I found on the ground, so that was a super exciting time. So we can use this pick on a... Okay, move! We're so slow! On a rock! Get ourselves some flint, which will now allow us to make a hatchet, and we'll make a torch, and we'll make a campfire. So we can start getting some meat cooking. You know what, maybe we can make a water skin, even. I don't think we'll need it, but that's still kind of just the basic stuff you always want to build right off the bat anyways, just for funsies. So I know most of you already know this, but where a pick is going to get better thatch and flint, a hatchet is going to get better stone. Oh, where'd that water skin go? Let's put that here and put some berries here so I have something to eat. It's going to get better stone and wood. Okay. What am I? I'm hungry. Let's eat some of this. And since we're just going to start with like a little starter hutch, I'm not going to worry about doing it over the water like I planned, but I'm going to throw a fire right here. I'm going to throw a sleeping bag right next to it. Can't place underwater. Okay. How about over here? Okay. How about up here on this rock? Just out of the way. Awesome. And now let's go ahead and throw some meat in here. I know I got a bit. Oh, I got a ton. With some wood. And what? What? Oh, no. Can I not light it because it's too much in the water? Stupid me. All right. So don't make that mistake. Go ahead and craft another one and put it not in the water so we can actually have fire. Right there on the edge like that. We like our fire on slopes. Okay, meat, wood, light fire. Let's get that stuff cooking. And then use this. I'm going to gather up a bunch of wood and a bunch of thatch. Oh, actually, ooh, I'm about to be overburdened. Maybe I need to be smarter about this. I need to make, like, a storage box or something first. Okay, so let's go ahead and learn our Ingrams. Let's level up. I'm thinking 150 stamina should suffice. Let's start upping weight, because we're going to need that. And let's learn what we need to learn. Bed, box, slingshot. Well, how many points? Oh, we have a lot of points. Oh, I did do that as well. I upped the amount of Ingram points you get per level, just so that we could not have to deal with that. But I will still show you guys about mind wipes and how those work eventually in one of the episodes. Okay, did we learn wood foundation? Wood wall? No? Are we going to have to start with thatch? I hate starting with thatch. Okay, well, we're going to start with a storage box for sure. So let's go ahead and craft that up. That I just learned storage box, maybe two. And we can just throw those down right on the ground, I believe. I don't think they need to be on a foundation or anything. Just so we can not have to... Oh! Okay, it's just an Oviraptor. They're fine. So this one will put all the berries in, and the other one will put all the materials in. So I'm going to go ahead and get the stuff organized. I'm going to gather us up a bunch of materials so we can start doing some building, and then I'll bring you guys back. All right, guys, we have gathered up a bunch of materials, and we should be able to craft an absolute ton of stuff. Let's see, thatch, fiber, wood. So I want to go ahead and start with just the wooden stuff. A lot of times people start with thatch. Because we have increased rates, it's really not necessary. Let's see, how many foundations make? 32? Let's make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Make a 3x3 house. Why don't we make a couple doors? There's a couple door frames. A couple doors. How many walls do we need then? So it'd be 12 around minus 2, so 10, 20 walls. Perfect, and then 9 ceilings. And that should get us started with a nice little 3x3 hut, so I'm gonna go ahead and let that stuff craft up. Alright, so we have crafted up all the pieces for our little starter house. What are these guys doing? They need to get out of where I'm gonna build. You guys are in my way. Alright, so first, throw down a foundation. Now these I'm not too worried about placement, simply because, this is just, like I said, a very temporary starter house. But let's make sure we make it all fit. Yeah, I think a little 3x3 makes for a really good starter house. Then we'll go ahead and put a one door right there. And then a nice little escape door out the back. Yeah. Alright, so just like this, I'm going to go ahead and get this sucker all the way built up. And I'll bring you back. Okay, so we've got ourselves a little bit of a little starting hut, and it's amazing. What we're missing, though, is this is a little bit tall to get in, so I think we need to go ahead and make a ramp. Let's see, R-A-M-P. Let's make two of those. And one should be enough on this side, and then one on the other side, I'm thinking. Let's go ahead and take that. Place it down right there. Beautiful. So now we can walk up easier into our little house. We'll do the same thing on the other side. Even though not really needed on this side, but to keep things looking the same. So now we have this big old empty house. We need to actually fill it up with stuff. So we're going to need some crafting stations. That's going to be a big one. Let's grab everything else we got here. We have some hide. We have some stone. The metal we're going to hold on to. So what we need to make some refining forges. Let's go 1, 2, 3, 4 of those. We need a mortar and pestle. We'll make 2 of those. Making more just allows us to obviously make, craft things faster. What else, we need a smithy? But we need metal for a smithy, right? Metal ingots. Man, it's been so long since I've done this stuff. I'll make a new campfire so we can cook inside. And then let's go to make some storage boxes, some of the large storage boxes, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now this house is gonna be very temporary. But it is good to get this stuff going. So once this stuff crafts up, I'm going to go ahead and place it inside our house. Oh, actually, we can start doing that right now. Look at that. We have refining forges, mortar and pestles, campfire, boxes. Let's get this thing going. So I'm thinking we'll put the boxes just straight in the back. Ugh, we move so slow when we're crafting. And we'll line them up just like this. Look at that. One. I'm not super worried about the placement because whatever. It's just temporary, you know? Two. It's funny how everybody places them like this, even though they are clearly designed to be, to go against the wall like this. Okay. Oh no, can we lift it 4 on this side? Should have put the door over one more. As close as we can. Okay, we don't want to block the door. So I guess 4 will do, because that's all the thing we have room for right now. Then we'll throw down our forges. One. Because we already have gathered a bit of metal just from hitting some stones with a pick. It's not a whole lot, so we will have to find some metal nodes pretty soon. But to start off, it's pretty solid. Maybe enough to make us a little bit of metal tools. Makes a big difference. Let's see, five. We'll throw the campfire over here. That's a, actually... Ugh, maybe we'll leave the campfire outside. Because... There's not a whole lot of room in here. Oh, actually, let's go ahead and make some beds. Let's go... We can make six. One, two, three, four. Four should be more than sufficient, I think. We're not going to die that much. We are not brand new to this game. We know what we're doing. Let's see. We also want to level up. Health, stamina. Let's go weight. Maybe 250. Awesome. I love that you can stack the beds on top of each other. So I can just throw one there. Another one on top. And another one on top. Another one on top. Wonderful. Awesome. So we have everything set up. So I'm going to go ahead and move all our stuff from outside to inside. And then we'll have ourselves a little bitty hut. All right. So everything is moved inside. And what we're going to need now is some raw metal. So we can go ahead and make metal ingots to make the next tier of stuff. Now, I don't know if there's any metal nodes really close to me. But I'm looking around for round river rocks. Rocks that tend to be really smooth. And, ugh, stupid pegomastics. Don't see me. They're gonna try to steal my stuff. They tend to be smooth and really round and right in the water. I don't know if there's a ton on this map or even in this area. But those, like, I don't think these qualify. They're not even in the water and they're not that round. I think those are just regular rocks. But they tend to give a little bit more metal. And early on, it does make a pretty big difference. Because it can be pretty tough to get metal early on. I don't know, let's try it. Let's hit one. Yeah, not even getting a little bit of metal. That's alright. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and look around for some and see what we come up with. I thought I saw someone on the other side of this. Okay, so I don't know if these qualify. These might just qualify as regular rocks, but we're going to try it. Maybe we'll get a little out of it. If not, we're just going to have to hit a bunch of rocks, or maybe I'll actually go look around. Oh, there's one metal! We're going to need a lot more than one, though. Oh, there's two metal! Oh, yeah! We're getting all the metal now! Three metal! Oh man, this is nuts. All right, check this out. So these are definitely the river rocks. See how they're all smooth and round? See if we get more metal. Two, three. Oh yeah, see way more metal from these suckers. I knew there were some around here somewhere. Oh, look at that, 10 metal, that's done. Now, obviously our rates are turned up, so you will get less on official servers and whatnot, but this definitely is gonna help us out quite a bit. All right. So all in all, we have gathered a grand total of 77 metal. And so we can go ahead, I'm going to split it into four wonderful stacks. One. And they got to be even numbers because two metal makes one ingot. And throw these in here and then grab a bit of wood. Wood. And divide that into four. And then we can go ahead and get some stuff going here. Once we get some metal, then we can make a smithy, and then inside that smithy we can make metal tools, and then with the metal tools we can get more metal, and the cycle just continues. While that stuff is... Wait, did I light you on fire? There we go. Light fire. Now, while that stuff's going, let's go ahead and make the next level up of armor. Some hide armor, I'm thinking. Oh! There's some metal in here, too. Alright, we'll throw that in this one. Okay, so what does it take to make the hide armor? Obviously hide. There we go. Hat. Boots. Gloves, chest, pants. Oh, we're gonna get the whole set, just barely enough to get it. Oh, we can actually level up a bit too here as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and get leveled up, get the new hide armor made, let this stuff smelt, and then I'll bring y'all back. All right, so the metal is just about done smelting, or just about. I think there's a little more that needs to be done, but I realize we're gonna actually need a little bit more hide if we want to make the smithy. Oh, perfect. Some of these little Listro, oh, level 85. I don't want to deal with that. There was another one over here, wasn't there? There's a moss chop. Those won't attack you either. Oh, was a fairy, though. That will attack me. What level are you? 65! All right, let's go back to that Listro. We can go ahead and kill him. A dodo would be better, but I don't see any dodos. Oh, there's some dodos over there. Man, this guy's close. Ah! He still shouldn't have that much health, but... Oh, I'm so sorry. Oh, it looks so sad. Come on. Go down. Ah, I broke a spear. Oh, so yeah, also I made spears. Just a couple, though. Alright, got enough hide, so now we should have everything that we need to make. A smithy. Let's check it out. And look up smithy. Beautiful. So this will allow us to make the next tier of stiff. Come on. Yeah, we can just throw this sucker right here against the wall. Oh, I forget. They hate to be placed really close to the wall, don't they? So stupid. Why won't they fix it? All right, there we go. Get close. Look at this big gap. There doesn't need to be a big old gap right there. What the heck? All right. Now, I think... Let's transfer all. Okay, so I want to make metal pick. That's number one. And then metal hatchet. That's also nice. And do we have enough to make the crossbow? Heck yeah, we're killing it. And the pike. We can make everything. The only thing that that will leave us with is the sickle, which we need to get fiber. But I think we can do without that for now, since I pretty much never use it anyways. Okay, so now that we have all the metal tools, I think it's time to... actually, we have to make some arrows for this crossbow, aren't we? What do those take? I don't even remember. Okay, thatch, flint, and fiber. Thatch, flint, fiber. Let's go ahead and make 100 of them! And so once these are crafted, I think we're going to start journeying out and go ahead and find ourselves some... Actually, you know what we should do real quick? We do need to get some metal. But before we do that, let's go ahead and... We should have some berries and some spoiled meat. Okay, let's grab the spoiled meat that we do have and throw it in the mortar and pestle. Go ahead and make a few narcotics being made, so we're going to need those soon. And in the other mortar and pestle, let's get some spark powder being made, which we're going to need some flint. Wow, that's really fast to make 100 arrows. And some stone. How much? We don't have a lot of stone. So we can go ahead and start getting some spark powder. So we can make some gunpowder for when we're going to need that. All right, there's a couple hundred of it. Let's do another couple hundred. And throw this stuff away. Make sure we got food and water so we're ready. Preload our bow. And we're going out looking for metal. Let's go on an adventure together. I'm thinking if we go up this way, that'll probably be our best bet. Just like straight up this hill. Oh no. Traveling out to go find metal the very first time when you're a lower level is the scariest part of the game ever. Because I know I need it, and I know it's close. I mean, I could tame something first and try to ride it there, which would probably be way safer, but I am impatient. And I'll just tame something next time. Okay, we got Dimorphodons. Where are we? Okay, ooh, those are Theri. But I know if we go across that land bridge up there, I think there's metal. If I recall correctly, which I always do. Okay. Ooh, compy, go away. Oh, all the compies, get out of here. Just take care of them before they start grouping up. Die, die, die. Oh, here they come. There's so many. There's one down. Compy battle. Just die. Look at all that. Oh, okay. It's just one of those guys. Stupid Diplos. There we go. Nice. Let's use our fancy new hatchet to get all the hide from these suckers since might as well. We murdered them. We deserve it. Dang. they dropped way more hide than you would think from the little tiny body. Where's the rest of them? Whatever. Good enough. Doesn't matter. We're not here for hide. We are here for metal. Okay, watch out for that Theri. I don't think they aggro unless you're really close, but man, can they do some damage. So far, this is going really well. No problems. No raptors. No rexes. I think we're almost there. Ah! Oh, you jerk! He stole my water skin! Oh, I hate those guys. Whoever decided... Okay, hold on. Alright, ARK dev team. Stop putting in the most frustrating dinosaurs in the world like the Pegomastix. They're useless for absolutely any reason to tame. And they're a huge pain in the butt. They steal crap from me. Ah! Alright. Is this where the metal is, or is it up higher? What is that? No, see, look at that! Look, he stole 100 raw meat from me! And I can't, I don't want to like chase him down and, oh, whoa. Ooh, that's a cave. Maybe we'll check that out one other time. We're not ready for that yet. Where is the metal? I could have sworn there was some pretty close here. I'm not crazy. And then we're gonna have to get back without getting robbed or killed. See, when it was just, oh, someone's building up here. That's Kevin. Oh my gosh, we could steal all his stuff right now. Look at all the metal he has! Just kidding, we're not gonna steal his stuff. He'd know who it was, I'm pretty sure he watches a lot of these videos. Oh, does that mean he already mined all the metal up here too? Kevin! Come on, there's gotta be a lot. Oh yeah, perfect. Ooh, that must be one of his birds. Here's some metal. We'll carry it, take as much as we can carry. Oh yeah! Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and gather all this stuff up and get home. Alright guys, so we got a little bit of crystal too because we did run into some. But we ended up with, let's see, I think it's just over 1,000 raw metal. Oh, I should probably, there we go, split these stacks. Whatever, it doesn't matter if they're even. So I split them up into these and we're gonna go ahead and get things smelting. And then there's just one more thing I wanna do today. Let's see, I wanna make a spyglass. So we need 5 wood, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 10 fiber. Because life with a spyglass is just so much better. Let's check it out. Come on. Perfect. Oh, so now we can look long distances and see the levels of crap. So I can be like, oh, what level is that parasaur? 35, what about that one? Ooh, that's a perfect parasaur right there. Level 150 is the max level on the server. All right, guys. But for today, I do think that is going to be it. We're just getting started today. If you guys did enjoy the video or if you learned something, do me a favor and hit that thumbs up button. And of course, feel free to subscribe if you have not done so already. You can also hit me up on all your social medias, your Twitter, your Instagram, your Facebook, and your Google Plus. Just search for ObediahX. So far, I think my Twitter is actually Obediah_X. You can also check out my Patreon at patreon.com/ObediahX. But like I said for today, guys, that is going to be it. I really do appreciate you guys coming to hang out with me. And until next time, I will see you later.